Have you ever asked yourself, why haven't my great-great-grandchildren appeared out of thin air in a plutonium-powered DeLorean? Why are people from the future not time-traveling to our period? First of all, it may sound wrong, but in my opinion, this time period isn't nearly as interesting to travel to as you might think. It is well-documented, possibly dangerous, and takes up a tiny sliver of the interesting history of planet Earth. Comparing to Earth's 4.5 billion years of age, the human race has only come into existence for about 4 million years. If we think of real human civilization as reasonably well-recorded history, we're restricted to the last 4 to 5,000 years. Once again, even when considered against the timescale of dinosaur existence, we're a mere eye blink in history. And because time travel is dangerous, due to paradox worries or the needs to simultaneously teleport on a galactic scale, because stars and planets move while the whole galaxy spins, and with pinpoint accuracy too, if you don't want to get stuck inside the Earth's crust or deep below the ocean, or in the worst case, you will be forever lost in the endless void. It sounds pretty poetic if you ask me. Or they're simply just very expensive. These options result in only limited trips being made, which relates back to the first issue. Our time period may not be worth the risk. Let's just assume that time travel is possible in the future. It might involve communication between two points in space-time. Thus, it would require such a device to exist at both points. So the device must be invented first, and that would be the earliest point travelers could go to. In another case, if we assume that the act of time travel creates an alternate, parallel timeline that diverges from the original, and also that your frame of reference is this original timeline, it will always appear to you that no time travel has occurred, because those events happen in an alternate timeline. Or they won't even need to travel back in time at all. There will be a method of seeing into the past that will alleviate the need for time travel into the past, avoiding any potential paradoxes or disruptions to the timeline. And in the worst-case scenario, nobody came back because there was no one left in the future. They either died or technologically regressed before time travel was invented. Pretty dark, eh? After all, these are just theoretical and assumptions, yes. So next time you see that strange guy with weird clothes smiling at you in the street, he's maybe your grandson from the future. Or he's just a creep. Who knows? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to share your thoughts on the video in the comment box below and suggest the topic you want the monsters to discover next.